नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी। टेंथ सब्जेक्ट साइंस, चैप्टर 10, लाइट रिफ्लेक्शन एंड रिफ्रैक्शन। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ विल स्टडी द न्यूमेरिकल कैलकुलेशंस। ए कॉनकेव लेंस हैज फोकल लेंथ 15 सेंटीमीटर। एट व्हाट डिस्टेंस शुड बी place the object from the lens so that it forms the image at 10 cm from the lens, and also find the magnification produced by the lens. See, dear students, now you are using the concave lens. Concave lens, you know that always forms a virtual erect image. This you have to remember. Always concave lens always forms a virtual and erect. See, I told you convex lens and convex mirror. So you have to remember like this: convex lens, concave lens, convex mirror, both are similar way that shows. And here image distance is how much? Image distance V is equal to negative 15, minus 15 even. Focal length, you see, focal length is, a concave lens has focal length 15 centimeter. Always in the concave lens minus, you have to keep the focal length. The object distance you have to find. Image distance is minus 10. Why? Because see, focal length is 15. Okay, at what should be placed is given. Okay, what should be placed? The object from the lens. See, image distance is given. Image distance is here. Should be placed so that it forms the image at 10 centimeter. So image distance will be 10 centimeter. Focal length minus 15. You have to find. You have to find. So you know that using the mirror formula, what? Lens formula, you have to 1 by V minus 1 by U, 1 of NF. So dear students, see, these steps you have to write. After the steps, what you are finding, 1 upon U is equal to 1 by V minus 1 by F. Then you have to fill up the value. Fill up the value means here 1 by V, 1 by minus 10, 1 by U, 1 by U, okay, 1 by minus 10, and 1 by V, see, 1 by U, F, 1 by V, you have to write 1 by V, what is you have to write? 1 by V is equal to, you are finding 1 by U is equal to 1 by V minus 1 by F. 1 by V, 1 by minus 10, and 1 by F you have to write 1 by minus 15. So write this one in the bracket also. So afterwards minus minus 15. So in LCM 30, this you are knowing. So U is equal to minus 30 centimeter you got. So the object distance is 30 centimeter. Okay, the object distance of what you got, 30 centimeter. The magnification Vm upon Vu, M upon V. Why? Because 1 upon minus 30, so 30 centimeter you got. So U is equal to 30 minus 30 centimeter. Okay, the magnification M is equal to V by U. So minus 10 and a minus 30. So it is left side, okay, distance. So you got the 0 point. So it means the positive sign shows that image is erect and virtual. So what the idea you got in this? The object is, see here, the positive sign shows that the image is erect, straight and virtual. The image is 1/3 right, small of the object. Now we'll see the next one. Example, a 2 centimeter tall object is placed perpendicular to the principal object of the convex lens of the focal length 10 centimeter. The distance of the object from the lens is 15. Find the nature, position and size of the image, and also find its magnification. See here the solution. Height of the object is given 2 centimeter. Focal length is positive sign. Why? Because you know that here convex lens used. Convex lens. Positive. And object distance will be U minus 15, image distance is there. And use the formula 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to 1F. So here you have to find the image distance you have to find. So that is why 1 by V is equal to, see, 1 by V minus 1F. 1 by is equal to 1 by U plus 1F. And you know that how to make these equations. And 1 by U, 1 by minus 15. 1 by V, you have to write plus 1 by this, and now minus sign will be there, and LCM is this. So you got the here V is equal to 30 centimeter. Okay, this 30 centimeter you got. The positive sign of the V shows that image is formed at the distance of 30 centimeter on the other side of the optical center, on the other side of the optical. The image is real and inverted. The image is real and inverted, you got. Okay, now you will see the power of lens. Power of lens. You have already learned that the ability of the science to converge or diverge light rays depends upon its focal length. So always the light rays converging is meeting, and diverging move away depends on its focal length. For example, a convex lens of short focal length bends the light rays large angle. See, remember these students, convex lens of short focal length bends the light rays through the large angles by focusing them closer to the optical center. Similarly, concave lens of very short focal length, see here, concentrate now, causes the higher divergence than the one with the longer focal length. So this you have to remember, these two lines are so important lines for understanding. So the degree of convergence or divergence of the light rays achieved by the lens is expressed in terms of power. See, the degree of convergence and divergence of the light rays achieved by the lens is expressed in the power. So what is power? The power of a lens is defined as the reciprocal of its focal length. So reciprocal, you are saying, it is represented by the P. The power of P is equal to, so that is why even is equal to this formula, you have to remember, P is equal to 1 by F. P is equal to 1 by F. Okay. Now, the dear students, here, the SI unit of power is not given here. The SI unit of power of a lens is the diopter, D-I-O-P-T-R-E. It is denoted by the symbol D. Okay. The SI unit of power is diopter. It is denoted by, what I am saying to? It is denoted by the D. If the focal length of the F is in the meter, then 1D is equal to 1 meter. So you have to remember, thus 1 diopter is the power of the lens whose focal length is meter. See, whenever any here, the focal length is given centimeter like this, you have to change in the meter. Okay? As per the new Cartesian sign convention, the power of the convex lens is always positive, and that of the concave lens is negative. So dear students, remember this also. Convex lens is here positive and the concave lens is negative. When an optician prescribes a corrective lens, the power of the lens is given to you. When the power of the lens of the spectacles is P is equal to positive 2.0 D, it means that a convex lens of focal length F is equal to 1 by P is equal to 1 by 2 is equal to 0.5 meter. Okay. So these are all this. And next one, the instrument used to measure the power of the lens is called diopter meter. So what is that? See, remember students, the instrument used to measure the power of the lens is called as diopter meter. Okay. Now, and one more thing you have to remember, that the degree of convergence and the divergence of the light rays achieved by the lens is expressed in terms of the power of lens. So that is why the definition of the power of lens is given by the reciprocal of the focal length. So power of the lens is equal to P is equal to 1 upon F. Okay. Here, two important points you have to remember. A convex lens of short focal length bends the light rays through the large angles. See, what you have to remember, dear students? A convex lens of short focal length bends the light rays through the large angles by focusing them closer to the optical center. So this one point you have to remember. Another point is, you have to remember that a concave lens of very short focal length causes higher divergence than one with the longer focal length. So second one, what you have to remember? A concave lens of very short focal length causes higher divergence than one with the longer focal length. Okay. Now, many optical instruments consist of a number of lenses. They are combined to increase the magnification and sharpness of the image. See, many optical instruments consist of a number of lenses. They are combined to increase the magnification or and sharpness of the image. The net power P of thin lenses placed in contact is given by the algebraic sums. So P1, P2, P3 as power is equal to P1 plus P2 plus P3. So like this way you have to use it. The use of the powers instead of focal lengths for lenses is quite convenient for the opticians. During the eye testing, you know that the optician puts several different combinations of the corrective lenses of known power in contact inside the testing the spectacle frame. The optician calculates and puts the several different combinations. The optician calculates the required power of the lens using the formula. For example, a combination of two lenses of power is positive 2.0D and positive 0.25D is equivalent to how much? Single lens of the power plus positive 2.25D. Students, so in this way the simple additive property of the powers of the lenses can be used to design the lens. The simple additive power property of the powers of the lenses can be used to design the lens system to minimize certain defects in images produced by the single lens. Such a lens system consisting of several lenses in contact is commonly, lenses are commonly used in the design of lenses of camera, microscopes and telescopes. So like this, in this way it is. Dear students, we have completed this lesson. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you for joining us.